Now, verse 16. But they have not all obeyed the gospel, for Isaiah saith, Lord, who hath believed our report? And we rejoice here on radio the number that write in and tell us they've accepted Christ, and it's amazed us how many. But when you look at the total picture, it's really a very small percentage, by the way. Who has believed our report? Now he goes on and says, verse 17, so then faith cometh by hearing, hearing by the word of God. And friends, I come back to this. I think this is God's method. I may sound like a stuck record to you, but I must say this. I believe that it's not actually by preaching philosophy or psychology or some political nostrum, but I believe that today it's the preaching of the Word of God. It's not what I think, it's what the Word of God says. Faith cometh by hearing. Hearing what? Hearing by the Word of God. And until you hear the Word of God, you can't be saved. Oh, how important that is. Verse 18, but I say, have they not heard? Yes, verily their sound went into all the earth, and their words to the ends of the earth. I would not want to say that Paul had this in mind, because I don't think he did. And I don't think that it has reference to radio. But I do want to say this, it sure has application there, that the sound has gone out today. And it's a marvelous way of getting the Word of God out. And you don't have to listen to it. Probably a very small percentage do. And I'm amazed that anybody listened to us, but they do. And we believe that God today will bless His Word. Now, will you notice, but I say, did not Israel know? First Moses saith, I will provoke you to jealousy by them that are no people, and by a foolish nation I'll anger you. And he's quoting here, of course, from Deuteronomy 32, verse 21. And what he's doing today is just simply this. God is calling out a people among Gentiles today. And he's going to develop that in the next chapter, by the way. Verse 21, but to Israel he saith all day long, have I stretched forth my hands unto a disobedient and gainsaying people? And have you ever stopped to think how tiresome it is just to hold your hands out? You try that. Just hold your hands out. See how long you can do it. That's the most tiring thing in the world that you can do. Just hold your hands out. You remember Moses went and prayed for Israel, and Aaron had to prop up his hands because he got tired holding them up toward God. But God says, I've been holding out my hands to a disobedient people. No one knows how gracious God has been to the nation Israel. And Stephen's final word to this nation is revealing. He says, ye stiff-necked and uncircumcised in heart and ears, ye do always resist the Holy Spirit. Now, that's not confined to just those people. That could be said today. That he's holding out his hands today to a gainsaying world. I marvel at the patience of God. I'll be honest with you, and I do not mean to be irreverent. If I was running this show today, this little earth down here, I'd make a lot of changes. I tell you, I'd move in. But you know, he's just holding out his hands to a gainsaying world today.